Historically, Wilson's known as the world's greatest tobacco market. In part, that's because we built our own electric distribution system to keep us, you know, with the times and to continue to grow. In today's world, you know, a lack of broadband is really just unacceptable, right? Because we rely so heavily on digital technologies and communication for everything we do. And now where we're really at is moving beyond the physical aspect to the connected people, both through the development of the ecosystem and through that physical fiber network. And so that broadband is just the next generation of that infrastructure investment.
Wilson, North Carolina has always been forward-thinking, pushing to become the tobacco center of the world in the early 1900s, to being one of the first cities in America to have an electrical grid, to being North Carolina's first gigabit city, an effort that brought gigabit speed fiber to the home for every resident and business in Wilson. That uncompromising conviction has led Wilson to become an innovation leader outside the state's research triangle.
So I've been a part of Greenlight since its inception back in the mid-2000s. And one of the jobs I had was to drive around from fire station with a disc, because there was just no infrastructure in the community at the time that was sufficient to transmit that kind of data remotely. And so our city leaders, council, and mayor realized that it was holding us back as a community. So they decided to, you know, make the investment to build the network, but then realizing, wait a minute, this is going to benefit the whole community potentially.
And so to build Greenlight was quite a risk at the time, and we're very grateful for that because I think it's helped us preserve our industry, and it's absolutely paved the way for Gig East. Gig East is Wilson's kind of stake in the ground of what we are and what we have to offer to the larger tech community and to really the Research Triangle ecosystem.
This facility, the Gig East Exchange, is in the heart of our downtown redevelopment area. We have been working diligently on downtown development over the last decade. It is important for Wilson to establish an entrepreneurial ecosystem instead of allowing those folks to get energized about an idea and feel like they need to go elsewhere to foster that.
It's not about people not leaving. It's about people not having to leave. Right? We want to create that choice and opportunity in our community too.
We wanted to send that loud message to say, you don't have to go elsewhere. You're carving a path here. We can support you in doing that, and we'll wrap the resources around you to make sure it can happen.
Better connectivity can usher in a new wave of rural prosperity and innovation, along with a new generation of young people ready to leverage the economic hub that's being established in Wilson.
So I was actually born and raised in Western New York. I grew up a huge, huge, huge NASCAR fan. I moved to the Charlotte, North Carolina area after high school to pursue a career in NASCAR. Then started as an intern with NASCAR Productions in Charlotte, North Carolina. I worked for them for 12 years and kind of worked my way up the ladder. And I left in 2014 to start my own company. I was based in Charlotte for a while. And then my partner Cameron got a job here in Wilson, North Carolina. And I decided to make the move with her. And so here we are in Wilson from via Charlotte, North Carolina. Being an entrepreneur, I'm carving my own path. I think it's really awesome in the world that we live in now. I can live in Wilson, North Carolina and have a client in Charlotte, North Carolina, and I never have to even get in my car. I have gigabit internet speeds here in Wilson. Because the city has made such a push for broadband for all to make it affordable and accessible to everyone that wants it. You know, I can have clients send me files on Dropbox or other file sharing services. You know, like, I don't have to leave my house to do what I'm doing now. 5 years ago, 6 years ago, I don't know that that's really the case, that I could live in remote, rural Wilson, North Carolina and still have these clients that are in major, large urban cities.
Willie Koch and I were extremely fortunate through Innovate NC to see all these co-working spaces and realize that was our vision for long-term here. To think that from that idea and that dream to realizing that in 3 years is pretty amazing.
To be in Wilson is to feel like you belong. And young people are starting to bring their talents back, invest, and have pride that they came from Wilson and to become a part of that community in a major way.
We haven't had a home. We haven't had this physical structure in the 4 years we've been creating Gig East. So the exchange is Gig East's physical location. It's the epicenter of everything that's happening with Gig East.
Gig East Exchange is going to be an amazing kind of turn the page moment for the city of Wilson.
Yeah, our first tenant will be one of the graduates of our first accelerator program, a company called Shift Auto, right? So we're bringing people with ideas together. We're helping them get those ideas off the ground and then translating that into new businesses in our community here.
What I love most about Wilson, the people. I mean, we're like a big family. We are that beacon of light. I had a couple of people contact me that are renting or using other locations for their office, and they're like, Carlton, we are getting ready to go over here. This is exactly what we need. Like, I'm excited about the opportunities that it's presenting, even more so just the ideas.
And to be quite honest, we believe in our exceptional nature as a community. You know, by working together, we can do anything. We have had success, and we will continue to have success.
There is always an energy and a sense of innovate, turn it up, turn it on, make it happen.
Everything starts with a thought, an idea. And Gig East is going to help people take their ideas and put them into fruition.
The world is changing. With a commitment to innovation, local government can build and leverage infrastructure to cultivate a thriving and connected startup ecosystem.